If you're scoring, you know, mid to high 60s in novice all year, it's time. Hi everyone, welcome to QnA Friday. Today we have two questions to answer. Our first one comes from Messenger, and this viewer has asked, I've been training at home and think I'm ready to take my horse out. How do I know I'm ready for a competition? So this is a really good question, and lots of people find different ways of answering it. In short, you know, you have to be comfortable with where you're at. So some people feel comfortable going out when they know they can do most of the test movements, but there's other people who are comfortable going out only when they can completely master the whole test at home for a month. So there's quite a bit of difference between these, you know, those two places in training, and you want to know what's comfortable for you and what's going to work best for you and your horse. And what you'll notice is that if you have competed dressage before, if you have competed to a high level, those riders often feel really comfortable going out when they can do the movements at home and they may not have even put it together in a test. I don't recommend not practicing the test at home ever before going out, but sometimes it happens. Circumstances can get in the way. So, you know, then there are other riders who really like the security of completely knowing the test inside out. They've practiced over and over and over at home, and they know that they've done the best they can possibly do to prepare, and they're ready to test it out in a competition atmosphere. So for most of my students, you know, again, I'll see where they're at and what their tolerance for risk is. And the other thing to consider is, do you get nervous at show? So if you get nervous, it's better to be over prepared than under prepared, because nerves will often empty your brain and you'll feel anxious because you're halfway through your test and you've forgotten, you know, the next movement, or you forget things before you even go in the ring, and you want to be able to bring all of that anxiety down and have a happy day that's reasonably relaxed. And to achieve that, you need more preparation than a person who is quite comfortable with being, you know, a little bit out of their comfort zone. So as a rule of thumb, I would say before you enter the show, because entries close, you know, between 2 and 4 weeks before a dressage show, before you've entered the show, practice the test at home. And how much of it can you get through? If you can get through all of it and you're reasonably comfortable, you're not going to make a fool of yourself, then go for it. You know, my rule of thumb is that if I can do all the movements, I may not necessarily be able to pull it all off in one test at home before entries. That's okay for me, because I know I've got another 2 weeks, and I know that in that 2 week period, I'm going to be able to pull my training together just that little bit more, and the horse will be a little bit better on the day. Find out what works for you. You need to do you to be comfortable at the end of competition day and say, oh yeah, I had a feeling that was going to go wrong and it did, you know, it doesn't matter. Or, you know, I got that right at home and I don't know why it went wrong here. Really, at the end of the day, you want to be able to say, these are the things that I got right and I knew I was going to get right. These are the things that I thought might not be so good, and indeed they weren't that good. And when you pick your test sheets up, keep those two things in mind. You know, if you know that your horse gets a bit tight on dressage day, your stretchy circles aren't going to be that good. You know, if you know that, you know, another thing that the horse can do is it might not get into some of its transitions as quickly. If there's a little bit more anxiety, or if the horse is reacting to the atmosphere, your transitions might not happen so smoothly. So take all that into account. You know, it does not matter. It does not matter what the test sheets say, as long as there's no surprises. And for me, that's the big one. I don't want any surprises on my test sheet. The things I do well, I want to get scored well for. The things that I don't do well, I expect a score to reflect that too. And, you know, when I know those things, I'm managing my own expectations. I'm not expecting to get a 70% for movements that don't deserve it. And I think, you know, if you can go in with that attitude, then it's going to be an educational experience as well as hopefully a fun experience for you and your horse. Okay, our next question, question two, has come from a student actually. Of course, when you have a coach and you're working regularly on your dressage, you will start going up the levels. And so this student has asked me, when should I go up a level? You don't want to be too uncomfortable going to the new test. You don't want to be so comfortable in your current level that every time you go out, you win, or every time you go out, you get the same score. You know, like it's great to get the be consistent, but if you're scoring, you know, mid to high 60s in novice all year, it's time. Move up, move on. There are other reasons not to. So, you know, say you've got work that is really, if your hours fluctuate, or you've got seasonal work and you know that you can't get the consistent work into your horse to be able to move up, or you've got other lifestyle factors that mean that you can't put the work in that will help you to go up a level, then, you know, by all means, stay comfortable, stay where things are workable for you. Only go up when you've got that opportunity to give it that little bit extra push or challenge yourself comfortably. So again, so when you're ready to go up, you'll be able to get through the test at home mostly. You'll be able to do all the movements at home separately, and you'll be able to put them all together for a test, but it doesn't have to be perfect. Once you can do that, then, you know, go up a level. As long as, you know, as long as you're comfortable with where you're at, by all means, go up. Often clubs like their riders to keep going up rather than staying in the same level and keep accumulating blue ribbons. And certainly in the EA rule book, you can't, you know, if you're riding officially and you're doing quite well, you will get pointed out of a level anyway. So there is that element of expectation that you will keep moving up and up. And, you know, take that. Clubs are there for riders to go and have a good time and enjoy their relationship with their horse and socialize. Clubs back off a little from that point of view, but it's still there as an influencing factor. So the other thing you want to avoid, you want to avoid going up too early. You know, if you really struggle, say you want to go from elementary to medium and you're really struggling with your flying changes in training at home, and you haven't even tried to put it together in a test, you know, you're not ready yet. The other thing is if you've got a really good change on one side and you can manage your way through the other side, then it's up to you. That would be, for me, I would probably go and have a go. Because don't forget, competition is a very different beast to training at home. And often that extra pressure or the extra atmosphere will, you know, could give you and your horse a little push for better performance. And sometimes the extra atmosphere and pressure is not a good thing for a combination. So it depends what kind of combination you are. For me, definitely the atmosphere and the pressure, you know, I need that to actually do a good job, to do a really, really good job. You know, I can get it right in training at home 100 times, 1,000 times, but I will do a better job in competition. Not everyone's like that. And then the other thing this student asked is, how many levels can I go up in a year? She was just, you know, is it possible, like, how, you know, to do more than one? And absolutely, 100%, it's absolutely correct. You can go up more than one level a year. You don't have to wait to be pointed out, and you don't have to wait to win a certain number of blue ribbons. If you're comfortable with what you're doing, by all means, go ahead. So in terms of pushing with your training, if you're working really closely with a coach, my expectation is that you would go up 2 levels per year. That also depends on the age of your horse. If you're riding a young horse, that's different. You are a little bit dictated by the horse's age. But if you've got a horse 8 or over, there's no reason why you can't go up 2 levels a year if you're working really regularly with a coach. For me, with Leo, he went up 3 levels in 18 months, I think. And then we got stuck at medium for a while. His changes took a very long time. We were in medium for 2 years, I think. And I think in that time we got pointed out of elementary. And then once the changes were established, I think we did maybe 3 advanced tests. We did just enough advanced to qualify for Prix St. George, and he was FEI. So he went really quickly into medium, then it was slow, and then really quickly into FEI. And there's not much difference between the advanced test and the Prix St. George. So, you know, for my students who are riding advanced, and if they're watching now, they'll know, you know, I just say, go and do Prix St. George, you know, because those tests really don't differ that much. Yeah, and you know, for some riders, getting FEI, going FEI is a real life goal. For others, they're quite, you know, they're happy staying in EA. So, and you know, it really depends on you. So what, you know, what are your goals with your horse? How many, you know, are you riding your tests yet? Are you competing your tests yet? Are you riding your tests at home? Or are you looking to be ambitious this year and go up a level or two? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. If you have a question for Q&A Friday, by all means, put it in the comments below. Don't forget to turn on notifications up there so that you hear about new videos every week. And yeah, we have 2 videos a week at this stage, and we have more coming soon. So great to be with you again today. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Okay, yay.